Hey guys, welcome back to Bliss Bar Home and Garden, and today we're going to make chili rellenos. This is going to be a casserole dish, and guess what? There is no frying, so it's so healthy for you. I hope you love this one. Let's get into the video. And we're going to brown everything, okay? And you know what? I wonder if I should do a fresh one. I wonder if it tastes better. And if there's not enough room on this pan for everything, no worries, I got another one. Take some of these off. And what I'm gonna try to do is try to brown the skin on everything. That way I can get the skin off of here. Okay, so we are going to make a fresh, also not so fresh, fresh and cooked salsa with this. So we're gonna take part of my tomatoes. I think I have 10 of them. So we're gonna take part of them, 1, 2, 3, 4 of them, and put them on the tray. And then we're gonna take one of our vine ripened tomatoes and stick it on the tray too. And then we're gonna leave the rest of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's more than that. There's probably 20 of them. I'm gonna take the rest of these and I'm gonna put a little bit more and make these ones fresh. Okay. That way we have a little bit of a mixture of fresh and not so fresh. So we're gonna bake our stuff at 350 in the oven until the skin is brown. Here's the other one. Meanwhile, I did not get Monterey Jack cheese because it was actually cheaper to buy this. Actually, it's probably cheaper to buy the other stuff, but I think Tallbrook does a better job with their processing, so I got this instead of the store brand. So that's why I have this instead of the store brand kind. So you're gonna wanna put this in the refrigerator because you're gonna wanna make it nice. The other one is still not quite ready yet, but it's done. The first bit. The other tray's gonna take longer. So flour. Okay, we'll just add the flour part for now. Over here, we're gonna work on our skin. It's still pretty hot, so be careful. If you are doing this, you might want to let them cool off. Or start digging around and hurting your fingers. We're gonna do several things. Okay, so we're gonna start by taking some leveling material. Then we're going to be using some cassava flour. You can use whatever flour you want. Mix it all together. And one of the things that I did not put in here, salt, which I don't know where my salt is at this point in time. Put some salt in here. little paprika. A little garlic. A little onion powder. We're also going to make chili relleno casserole. With a little extra twist. Which I'm still trying to think of if I want it now. You might have that on the side, come on. So. Take your chili relleno and dust it off here. Put it in your pan. The other thing that you're going to need is this big block of cheese. And you can use whatever kind of cheese you want. You can use the Monterey Jack cheese if you want to, okay? I just did this instead. I need a big knife. It's good. Thank you. Alright. Let's add the yellow okay, so what you can do is, it depends on the chili though at the time. You can take your seeds out if you want to, whatever you really want to do. And then you can take your skin off too at the same time. Hurt your feelings too. Thank you. for this because I think there's like 10 or 20 chairs in there. Six, seven. yourself a chile relleno baked. So yummy. So cheesy. Let this baby open. There's cheese inside of there. Yummy, 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 yummy. Yummy, guys. Mm-hmm. It's yummy. Very yummy. So, thanks for watching today's Food is Flower Home and Garden. I hope you guys enjoy this one. I hope you inspired you something wonderful in your life, no matter what it is. Inspire other people to do something wonderful in there. Thanks for subscribing to today's video. And we'll see you next time on Food is Flower Home.